Looking back at high school makes me feel like college prep acceptance was overblown. I don't know if it's just me, but I'm junior, still sophomore based on credits, now at my local state school. I've been thinking back to the SAT prep and all that stuff we had drilled into our heads during our junior and senior years at high school. The weird thing is that high school made getting accepted to college feel like this big thing, but now it feels like almost nothing at all. Does anybody else have a similar thoughts about this? Response 1.
Now the big thing is getting an internship, and in a few years it will be getting a job offer.
What's after that?
Retirement. Death.
I wish, lol.
Boy, have I got some good news for you.
Pretty much the only thing we're guaranteed at this point.
Response 2.
I never even took the SATs in high school because I wasn't planning on going to college. I never had dreams of getting into some Ivy League, so when I decided to go to college, I just went to the college closest to me at that has a 96% acceptance rate. Got in at 19 years old. I wasn't surprised and didn't really feel any feeling of accomplishment, but I am the first person in my entire family to go to college, so that's cool. I do remember senior year of high school, all the seniors got a form to fill out during homeroom during the last weeks of school. It said, what college do you plan on applying to and what will you study? Back then I put my name on the form and left the questions blank because I had no intention of going. 2 hours later I got called to the principal's. They asked me why I didn't fill out the form. I told them I wasn't going to college. The principal said just write down our state college name. The only reason I can think why they would need me to fill out that form so bad was so that the high school could say, 98% of our students go to college.
There's a high school in DC that claimed all its students were accepted to a college. This got the attention of NPR, which wanted to do a story about it. In their research, they found that a third of those students didn't even qualify to graduate. It caused the FBI to launch a fraud investigation.
You mean in Louisiana? Louisiana was the one faking application documents.
Response 3.
I think it depends on where you went. Going to a competitive school definitely opened doors for me and still feels like an accomplishment. However, exact rankings are so much less important. Basically just falls into top school, good school, and average school.
I guess that's sort of true. I always felt like I lowered my own standards by applying for state schools in the form of lower entry scores on SAT and ACT as opposed to other places. Regardless, it's a lot more bang for your buck emo than going elsewhere for a degree.
Definitely. All schools get the job done, some have extra perks, but those perks may or may not be useful.
Quote, all schools get the job done. This is definitely not true. Your chances of getting a job with a degree from XYZ Community College are not the same as with a degree from Harvard, etc.
Response 4.
Well, of course. Once you achieve something, it soon means nothing to you again. Just think about all of the things you've achieved in the past. Got a good grade on an exam 4 semesters ago. Got invited to a party in your first week. Whatever you can think of, if it happened more than maybe a month ago, I can almost guarantee that you don't really care about it anymore. Sure, you can still be proud of it, but you're not going to lie awake at night smiling over that assignment you did well in 3 years ago because it isn't a part of your current life. Same thing applies to SAT, ACT and university applications. The moment you submit them, you may as well burn them. You'll never need them again, literally no one gives a shit about what you did in HS, and you'll soon forget even what classes you did in your final year. The fact that you no longer care is a good sign. It means that you've moved on and found more important things to think about. The only people happily reminiscing on their HS stats and the application process are the people who peaked there and have since been a failure in whatever sense. If someone is failing university but did well in HS, you can be certain that they'll tell you all about their old GPA.
This was so uplifting, thank you.
Response 5.
I disagree. While yes, it might have been overblown. Getting into a top college requires FHST hard work for at least 90% of people. And at least going to one myself, that name allows you to get your foot in the door much easier.
Response 6.
I went back to school at 26 to get my first bachelor's, and worked my ass off in community college to get accepted to the school that denied me back when I was 17. Sure as shit feels like an accomplishment to me. I get it, though. In my classes I'm surrounded by kids who got into university right out of high school. These are kids who've always done well in classes, whose parents helped them with homework or applications or whatever else, who had access to SAT prep materials, who actually had people telling them they needed to study, maybe someone even took the time to show them how to study. If you've got all that stuff, I can see how it might not feel like you personally accomplished anything. It's more like you've just been following the path the adults set out for you. But think about how things might have been if you didn't have any of that. What if your parents never helped you with anything school-related, never looked at applications with you, never cared what your grades were like? What if your family didn't have money for prep materials, or even food? What if your school didn't bother with college talk because they didn't think any of you would have a chance to go? What if, despite having no help whatsoever, you still managed to get accepted to a good school? Would it feel like an accomplishment then? So, if you're feeling like getting into university wasn't that big a deal for you, well, maybe it wasn't. Maybe you were helped along so well by the adults in your life that university just feels like the next step in the boring slog you've been railroaded into since childhood. That's okay, it's fine to feel that way. But, before you start talking to folks about how easy it was to get in and how being there feels like nothing, think about who's nearby. There's a good chance the person right next to you had to fight tooth and nail through an endless mire of bullshit just to get accepted anywhere, let alone this amazing school, and overhearing you talk about how getting accepted was no big deal might crush whatever glimmer of pride they were starting to feel about themselves. I've overheard that conversation far too many times, and while I'm usually good at remembering that the kids talking like that don't understand how lucky they were, it still hurts. I still end up feeling like all the work I put in was only necessary because I'm an idiot. Don't be the person who makes someone feel that way.
Thank you. As a fellow older student, 26, it is a bit annoying to hear typical younger student talk about how easy it is. Or if I asked for clarification because it had been 10 years since I took a chemistry class and a kid scoffs to the side talking about how he can't believe I wouldn't know something because he learned it in high school last year. I fought, literally and metaphorically, for my ability to go to school on my own terms. The ones that get to learn in college right out of high school are the lucky ones. The teachers are right, if you don't use it, you lose it. Maybe that's why college feels like nothing to some students.
Response 7.
I'm 27. Have 90 college credits from 4 different institutions. Never had to take the SAT or ACT. Had to take a placement test when I first started at 22 though, but you aren't supposed to study for those.
I kinda went the same route as you. After this semester I'll have 90 credits from 3 different colleges and am turning 23 next month. Emo, it really doesn't matter what college you graduate from so long as it's accredited.
For me, it's just about where I finish. Most schools want your final 24-30 to come from them in order to grant a degree. Switching to a big state university at the start of the summer should be my last stop. Finish my bachelor's and work through a master's there.
However you do it is still an accomplishment. What are you graduating with for your bachelor's and what master's program are you looking at? Personally, I'm graduating with a psychology bachelor's and am applying to a master's clinical counseling program. Edit, oops, just saw your cryptozoologist tag.
The tag is a joke. It's not a real major. Would be cool if it were and I could make money. Nah, exercise science and health promotion for the bachelor's and then a master's in the same. Basically a high-end personal trainer nutritionist. Going to work with the VA afterwards.
Response 8.
Honestly, I just winged the SAT tests. Edit, apparently, I got a 1600 out of 2400. Good times.
How to have a less stressful academic career. Wing SAT. Get 1130, 1600. Go to lower end state school. Knock out your Gen EDs, which will be much easier than if they were at a big state school. Transfer after 2 years to a big name state school. Graduate with a degree from big name state school at only 1/2 the cost. Profit.
At least in CS, the students that did this struggled pretty hard in my school after transferring from elsewhere after 2 years and had to work extra hard, especially as the safety barrier of being a freshman and making mistakes was gone.
Response 9.
I think it's a lot different if you come from a family where your parents don't expect you to go to college, and never went to college themselves.
It feels the same as Op said.
If you say so. I used to volunteer at the Career Center in a few low-income high schools and many of those students certainly did not feel that way.
Response 10.
May depend on your state. At the time I graduated high school, you could earn a college prep diploma by completing certain courses. The state said you were absolutely ready for college with that seal on your diploma. The problem was that the state university system had nothing to do with it. They had no input into the credits required or the difficulty of the coursework or any other details. In short, it really meant nothing in my state.
Response 11.
Oh God, yes. They made it seem as if you might as well kill yourself if you didn't get exceptional grades and get into a top university. I burned out from the stress and got booted out of the grade-obsessed school. I go to a nice, easy-going new school, find everything's a breeze because they didn't lay the same expectations on so thick, get to uni and bam. I realize it was in no way as massive a deal as they made it out to be. In absolutely no way as big of a deal. The fuckers.